1968, the Church of England opened Cloverley Hall Conference Centre. This was to give pastoral care to families who came to the centre. They had a great holiday here, as well as learning more about the Christian religion. It was a beautiful place. It had gardens one side and a woodland the other. And there was a lake less than 100 yards away at the back where you could do boating or swimming. Prior to that, of course, it was Cloverley Hall Boys' School. This was formed 18 years before, and it was run by the Reverend Duncan, headmaster. Reverend Duncan had been a missionary in the Arctic, but due to ill health, he came back to England and was the headmaster of Cloverley Hall. Here you see are the dormitories that we lived in. We started off in this dormitory when I was about 7 years old, and I slept in various beds around the wall. And then as we progressed, we went into this next dormitory, which was supposed to be better, but it was so cold. There was a half inch gap between the door, which led straight outside. As you can see now, they put an awning around there and they put another concrete floor to raise it up a bit. And that's where my bed used to be, under the ball ring. I slept in various places around the wall, but I remember one year I slept there. Well, as you got older, you went through the five dormitories and eventually you ended up in the loft. This is where my bed used to be. One advantage of being upstairs in the loft, the hot air rises, and of course it was a lot warmer. And there was a proper toilet you could go to, where down the bottom you had to wee in a bucket. After making our beds in the morning, we had to go down and do breathing exercises. Right down in the quad there. Here is the assembly hall, where movies used to be shown and slideshows, and of course it was a gym. There were parallel bars on that wall, and down here of course is where you go to two classrooms. This is where I started school, in this bottom classroom, which is below ground level, and we had a small stove to keep us warm, but it was very cold and damp. And then, of course, we used to go upstairs to the second classroom. This was the toilet that I spoke about. Well, here's the portcullis where we used to line up every day for meals. We used to line up outside, and then they used to open the doors, and we used to go inside for breakfast, dinner or tea. Along that wall, of course, there was hooks. And here's the dining room, looking a lot better than it did in our day. All we had was benches to sit on, and there was a headmaster at the end of each table. As you can see here, these are the families that enjoy the hospitality now of the conference centre. A lot better now than it was in our days. Through these doors, of course, was the headmaster's domain. And in here was the assembly hall where we used to go every morning for morning prayers, and the headmaster used to conduct it. Next door, of course, this was a place of intrepidation, especially if you had a conduct mark and had to go and see the headmaster, because this was his office. But on Sundays, it was used for Bible reading, and we used to sit there round the fire and listen to Bible stories. Of course, inside here, there was a beautiful oak staircase that used to go up the landing to the private quarters of the headmaster. And of course, there was a small dormitory up there where the prefects used to live. And this is the view that they used to see out of their window. This is the door leading out of the passage where the headmaster's area was. And out here, we used to have Bible reading in the summer. Very nice. And of course, in those days, the gardens were immaculately kept by the boys, because every Thursday we used to have to do gardening, which we had to do the weeding of the beautifully kept gardens. And also we had to go into the grounds where we had to trim the trees and mow the lawns and rake up the grass. And as you can see, it's a very nice area. And these are the rhododendron trees. This is the woodland that we're looking at the moment. This is the other side of the drive of the school. And of course, there's rabbits and pheasants and birds singing all the time. A very angelic place. The trouble is that I wasn't happy. Bats in the belfry. There used to be bats that lived up there, but the clock used to chime every hour, so we always knew what time it was. Down in the crypt, we used to keep our sporting clothes, and we all had a box. My box was number 60. Well, the old oak tree. This is the old oak tree that I used to learn to climb on. A lovely old tree that you could sit in the fork there. This is the side entrance to the school and the only entrance that we could use. And this goes onto our playground. I learned to roller skate on this playground. And this big building that you can see on the right hand side is a dod. This is where we used to have cold showers every morning. And we used to have a bath once a week. The juniors, there used to be two in a bath. Here's a view at the back of Cloverley Hall. And as you can see, that once there used to be a lot more of Cloverley Hall, which was knocked down. But there is a link on the blog that will tell you more about that. The crypt is underneath that area. But here we have Cloverley Hall as is today. And the top three windows up there are the classrooms. Very nice view looking over this area. I did spend the last year, I think, of my school year there. And of course, here the children of today, enjoying the relaxing atmosphere of Cloverley Hall, which is now a bit different from the times when I was there. And under this monkey puzzle tree, we used to sit as well on Sundays, where the headmaster used to read Bible stories out of the Bible. Also, we had the crusaders in the afternoon on the Sunday, and we used to go long walks as well. Well, the end of the summer term, of course, was school sports. And one year I was there. There I am up there. And, of course, it was the end of term, a great time. And, of course, there was sports being played and everybody was happy. There's a tennis court. Dad even contributed money for that tennis court. And there am I, a fine chap. Well, there we are, Cloverley Hall School for Boys, which was operating for 18 years. And I was there for a large part of it, at least 7 years of it. Was it good or was it bad? Unfortunately, people didn't know about dyslexia in those days, and there was only two qualified teachers, the headmaster and one other, and which I didn't get the schooling I should, but I don't think it was the fault of Reverend Duncan. I think he did his very best. I think he was the old school and believed in bringing up kids tough. Reverend Duncan offered a service for parents to send their children to boarding school without an entrance exam. I wasn't meant for boarding school, so the ownership, really, is my parents. I shouldn't have been sent.